And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Nightfall Control. This is a deck that I have that I built myself that I've been playing off of stream and really enjoying. Just kind of basically putting together a deck filled with good cards that, you know, I think have a good chance of winning. Basically, that's kind of like where the deck idea started. I wanted to play a deck with Hush. Basically, what I wanted to do, I guess kind of starting this is, I probably started this deck a few days ago whenever we were playing against, like, Fiora Zoe and Zoe Lee Sin a whole lot. Those decks were super popular, especially, like, Fiora Zoe was super popular. And I wanted to have a deck that had a great matchup in those kind of decks, against those decks. So I wanted to have Hush, and I wanted to have, like, Vengeance. I wanted a hard removal spell. You know, they use, like, a bunch of buff spells on something. I wanted hard removal. So I wanted Vengeance, Hush. And so I kind of ended up here. I also kind of wanted to use, like, some just different champions and everything like that. So, you know, I wanted to play Diana. Like, Diana and Nocturne are both very good champions that I think are very underrated. And so I wanted to give them a try. And so we're kind of playing a bunch of Nightfall stuff with them. Both Diana and Nocturne in this deck are basically used as removal spells, right? Like, you get your quick attack challenger with Diana. That's just a really cheap removal spell. Even Nocturne. Nocturne, a lot of the time in this deck, like, sometimes you'll level it up and, you know, give your things fearsome and finish the game off with it, which is awesome. But a lot of times you're looking at, like, a 4-mana, 5-damage removal spell. You know, like, with the Nightfall, you give something, like, you get to grant whatever you want vulnerable, and you can use this as a really good removal spell. So, like, they're both awesome at killing champions and keeping the board clear. And then, you know, you have your Nightfall cards, your Invoke cards. You have your Invoke cards that just win, you know, win late games for you. You know, it's with Targon. Another thing that I love about Diana and Nocturne is they both have absolutely amazing champion spells. That's one thing that I just absolutely love here. Like, Pale Cascade is one of the best cards in the game, and Diana gives you more opportunities to play Pale Cascades. And Nocturne gives you Unspeakable Horror, which is an amazing spell, which, you know, by the way, can get you even more Pale Cascades in a roundabout way. So both of our champions have absolutely amazing champion spells, two spells that we're playing three of in here, Unspeakable Horror and Pale Cascade. So yeah, we have Hush, we have Pale Cascade, we have Unspeakable Horror, and we have more ways for even more Pale Cascades and Unspeakable Horrors. So awesome interaction in here. Let's see. And then, yeah, you know, like, you have your late game of, like, Eclipse Dragon, Nightfall, getting you dragons and Celestials, Star Shaping, getting you those Celestials. So with this deck so far, I've done very well off of stream with this deck so far. But I've also not really played against a really wide variety of decks. Basically, I've played against a lot of aggro and then a lot of, like, the Zoe Fiora and Zoe Lee Sin decks. What I haven't played against and what I think will be the most difficult matchup for us are Aurelion Sol decks. Because Aurelion Sol, I think, is just the best top-end card in the game. And so I think that's the kind of matchup that I think that we're going to struggle against if we play against Aurelion Sol decks. But besides that, I'm very confident in our deck doing well against, you know, most everything else. All right, so let's give it a try. Another cool thing about our deck, now I know, like, this would, like, it's rank up Sunday today. We're kind of playing these decks. Like, I'm picking out, like, three decks, like, that could be, like, a good lineup that I would play right now, like a lineup for a seasonal tournament. And if you were playing in a seasonal tournament, your opponent would have your deck list, so you wouldn't really fool them with this kind of deck. But in just for now, you know, because that's 50 days away and things are going to get buffed and nerfed and stuff like that, things will change. But for now, all we have is ranked, and in ranked, they don't see our deck list. But they do see Diana and Nocturne and Shadow Isles and Targon. And so a lot of people think that I'm an aggro deck. Alright, Go Hard is our first real match. I kind of want to keep this Eclipse Dragon. I'm going to keep this Eclipse Dragon.
Only a fool would enter battle unprepared. It's our time.
Yeah, this the blue monkey here, yeah, this one's pretty awesome. This was part of, like, kind of part of, like, the KDA stuff, whenever they with the KDA stuff. So I don't know if you could just buy the Guardian on its own, or maybe it was part of a KDA package. One of those two. I want to block here and then create the gem and then be able to attack again and have another gem. But if they do have Gohard and then kill, like, basically, like, we can kind of assume that they have Gohard. And if I make this block and then they Gohard my goat, that's kind of a little rough. Like, I would rather block here in that case. So I think that I'd just do this. Just make sure to get Elise off the board. You know, so that was the safe play. That wasn't the highest upside play. And let's see, we'll do this. We're gonna take the Trickster. No, maybe I just take the Messenger. Trickster. I want to keep the Dust Petal Dust for my Eclipse Dragon, so we can have, like, turn 6 Eclipse Dragon with Nightfall. Yeah, I could play Messenger now, but I'm not going. I'll just Unspeakable Horror this, like, little 1/1. Because I have Nightfall turned on right now. I'm not always going to have Nightfall turned on. I mean, I guess I could wait till next turn, but this allows me to attack with the 2/1. Or they have that. Okay, well, it didn't work out the best for me, especially with that Glimpse Beyond. So right now we're looking at Gohard and Glimpse Beyond for Spell Thief. Yeah, Steel Gohard's pretty slow. I mean, yeah, it would take way too much time for me to get to Pack Your Bags. For the most part, like, I want to... So, the best use for Spell Thief, the best possible Spell Thief, is right after they play Pack Your Bags, then I Spell Thief, then I grab Pack Your Bags, and I recast Pack Your Bags on them and do 5 damage to all their things because they go wide and everything. That's my best possible use for Pack Your Bags. Now, that isn't the most likely use necessarily, or not most likely use, but that's not the most likely thing to happen, right? Because you only get to pick 3 enemy spells, and they've already played, like, multiple Pack Your Bags, they've already played, like, a Glimpse Beyond, multiple Gohards, they've already played a Glimpse Beyond, as we see there. So they would already have played a good amount of stuff, so it's not easy. It's not, like, it's not guaranteed that you grab Pack Your Bags, is what I'm trying to say. Good card. Darn. I was really hoping they would play something else here. I wanted to Ruination this turn. This was my plan, was this Ruination. So we're at 8.
Gotta go with the flow.
Not a whole lot of life. Sequencing with this deck is very tough. So many options all the time, every turn. Maybe should have played, like, I maybe shouldn't have gone straight to attacks. Like, I maybe should have had, like, this kind of stuff first. Spacey Sketcher's not bad. That's a great card. That's smart. Wiggly Burblefish in this deck is actually awesome. Yeah, that's actually awesome. This is a great Wiggly Burblefish deck. Yeah, like that's awesome. I need to play a lot more things before attacking that last turn. I need to play, like, this kind of stuff before attacking. Yeah, I need to. How I played that last turn cost me this game. Good learning game. And great game for the opponent. With Burblefish, awesome. Absolutely. List is here. Alright, I like this hand. Well, I could play Lunari Dustbringer and attack for two. I think that just saving Lunari Dustbringer for the Nightfall for all this stuff is more important. Now with them playing the goat, obviously I need to play a blocker and not allow them to just attack with the goat. No free attacks. The Grand Plaza. That's gonna be a problem. That's actually something I haven't faced with this deck, because I have not actually faced Grand Plaza either. So as I talked about, I played against a bunch of aggro, and I had faced Go Hard, right? So I faced aggro, Go Hard, and Zoe, Fiora, and Zoe Lee Sin. But I hadn't played against an Aurelion Soul deck, which, as I said, I thought that Aurelion Soul would be pretty tough. And I actually hadn't played against a Grand Plaza deck with this yet. So I think my best play here is to... I know I could Hosh this Solari Priestess. Well, that doesn't seem worth it. I'm going to look for... I wanted to look for the Obliterate and just obliterate this Grand Plaza. Did not find it. Do I want a Written in Stars or a Golden Sister? I want a Golden Sister. Bask in her radiant blessing.
Devotion through battle.
These three currently, right now, Delphinus, the three that we're playing, that was like the whole point of this rank up Sunday. If there was a seasonal tournament immediately right now, these would be the three decks I'd register.
Oh, man.
But yeah, I think this is going to be the toughest matchup for me with this specific deck is Grand Plaza, Aurelion Soul. That's what... talk about at the very beginning. I'm not super confident here.
Lunari, rise! Back, heretic.
but we'll see. I mean, I made this deck earlier in the week. I was 7-1 with this deck off of stream. I think this deck's really good, but like I said, I think this is a tough matchup. I think that Go Hard deck, I like my matchup against Go Hard. I think that they had a good version with the Burblefish and stuff, and my hand was kind of awkward with having, you know, so many Vengeances and stuff, but Vengeance and everything, but I think they played very well. I lost, but that doesn't mean it's not a bad matchup. I would play this against Go Hard over and over, and I'll confident I'll win 60 out of 100, but I'll still lose 40 of them, and that was one of the 40 I'd lose. But yeah, like I said, before playing this, I'd won 7 of the 8 games, but I hadn't played a very big variety of matchups.
My spirit shines.
Useful.
Ah, look at this reality! Sparkly! What once was two, now is one.
Next thing I'm worried about is Aurelion Soul next turn, but them kind of tapping out here. If they just spend 8 mana on Aurelion Soul next turn... Oh no, I'm one short. Never mind, now that I use that, I don't have the 3 spell mana anymore. I'm one short, I don't have Hush plus Ruination. Yeah, I guess Aurelion Soul is still going to be a problem. Yeah, I'm one mana short.
Devotion through battle.
Oh wait, they can't play Aurelion Soul next turn. It costs 9 mana, not 8. Never mind, they can't play it next turn. Okay. Not sure if I should be casting Glimpse Beyond on one of those, maybe. So if they want to use some kind of spell that, you know, like a silence, you know, like they want to play like a Hush or something like that on my Diana, good news is they wouldn't have the mana to play Aurelion Soul then if they do that. Yeah, I didn't think so. I think they want to play Aurelion Soul this turn.
I created it.
Eons old, and still no manners.
Definitely the card I'm scared of the most in the entire format is Aurelion Soul. They already have two awesome invoke cards. Like, even if I can remove it here, like, they got two awesome invoke cards, and I had to use a Hush. Alright, so which one of these two do we want to play? This is a, you know, pretty good pretty good spot for Ruination, I suppose, with me not having anything else, but I kinda wanna do this Supernova instead. Cause maybe they play more units here that could do like Ruination on my turn.
Okay, good.
Interesting. That's interesting. Oh yeah, Crystal Ibex. I got you. Yeah, Crystal Ibex is an underrated card. But there's so many great cards in Targon that it's probably not worth one of the 40 just to give like a Aurelion Soul Overwhelm. Usually, if you have like a Aurelion Soul in play, you're probably winning anyway. I don't think there's too much difference whether a Aurelion Soul has Overwhelm or not, probably. But I do like Crystal Ibex a lot, just as a card.
Spilled paint is just accidental art.
Yeah, Ibex is great with dragons. If you're a more dragon-focused deck with a Aurelion Soul. Cause yeah, it's great with the Eclipse Dragon and Inveolus Vox, all that kind of stuff. Alright, Nocturne's now at 4. It doesn't seem like it, but we have attacked with 4. Four Nightfall things. That's a good trade for me, though. Obviously, like, the Eclipse Dragon for that Charger. What's that thing called? The Destroyer? Yeah, that's a great trade for me, trading with the Destroyer.
My spirit shines.
Alright, what'd they just play? Another Written in Stars? Yuck.
The hour is mine.
So they could have another 9 mana Aurelion Soul. Like if I played this. Look at them, maybe having another Aurelion Soul. I guess I could find the Obliterate. Cool. I could have Hush Obliterate. That could take out Aurelion Soul. That was the perfect card to find. That's because I have the perfect mana with 8 mana for that. Alright, 2 Aurelion Souls down.
Your favorite star. I created it.
Eons old. And still no manners.
It's possible they're only playing 2. That's certainly possible.
Your
These invoke cards are awesome when you're not playing against other invoke cards. But playing invoke mirror matches, you just spend 4 hours playing one game. Like, I think this game started yesterday.
Strike quickly, strike boldly.
We're only halfway through the decks. I can double vengeance to kill that thing, or I could just mind splitter it. Mind splittering it isn't too reliable of an answer, but somewhat of an answer. So it causes, maybe this isn't a really insult deck. Yeah, I mean it. The thing is, like, if you're in a seasonal tournament, you can only play one Aurelion Soul deck, right? And so, like, I would have that with the Aurelion Soul Leona. And Aurelion Soul is great. Like, Aurelion Soul wins, like, these kind of games. Like, it wins the Targon Mirror, but it's not a necessity against any other deck, basically. Like, with the deck that I'm currently playing. I really don't need it in any other matchup except for this kind of Targon Mirror. The Invoke Mirror. I'm sorry, I wasn't able to save the puppy. I mean, I guess I could have with the Unspeakable Horror.
Justice will be served.
Didn't get to save the puppy. I like this Nocturne draw quite a bit. I'm gonna try to use it to take down the Immortal Fire. Now it's only an 11-5. That -1/-0 was pretty big. Like, this game's still 20-18. And, like, if this works, it's 20-18 with a free, with a, you know, with an empty board, basically.
They will all scream as one.
Like, the card advantage in Targon is ridiculous. You just never run out of cards. Nobody can ever win. No, yeah, with the leveled up Nocturne, we had Pill Cascade covered. Gran Antonio! Get that second month resub in here. Thank you so much there, Gran Antonio.
Cool.
You think this is a Living Legends turn? I don't know. I was kind of thinking just doing that. And being able to wait even longer on Living Legends. But yeah, maybe last turn was the Living Legends turn. Maybe it was. When you have a leveled up Nocturne already, you don't have to play this as a Nightfall card anymore. Like, it doesn't give you any bonus for playing as Nightfall. So, like, I can lead with that. And then, you know, again, I have Unspeakable Horror, which is, you know, so then I have, like, multiple Unspeakable Horrors and a Pill Cascade. And I think I'm just going to do that instead of play Living Legends.
A nightmare for every mind.
Son, this, move that, adults are boring.
So they have this card right here is something they grab with Star Shaping. So some amazing invoke card. I'm not interested in them spending their 13 mana. I would rather just me spend all that mana and then just pass the turn. So we don't know what that, like, again, they have something, like, they could have, you know, they could have like their own Living Legends, Immortal Fire. They have something that costs 7 or more. This card right here. Some invoke card that costs 7 or more. So I have to be a little wary of that, especially if it's like an Immortal Fire or something. Like that, it could be very powerful. Let's see. So if I play my own Immortal Fire, you know, I wouldn't have like Vengeance or anything like that available. I can probably just pass right now. All right, so that's it. It's probably Living Legends. That's what it looks, especially how they're going like this. Well, I don't know. Do Burst Spells do that? I guess Burst Spells don't do that. So yeah. Okay. So that was their powerful 7 mana card. Not bad. I'll take that. It could have been much worse for me. Dude, that's what I'm talking about, though. Green's like, how long has this game been going for? I mean, Targon games never end. We're at 52 minutes right now between last game and this game. Two games, 52 minutes.
Like this.
This is the problem with these celestial cards. You can't lose if you play Celestial cards. So if both people play Celestial cards, then both people can't lose.
Paint your feelings.
Scoochie says, I want aggro to be meta again. I hate long games. I kinda agree. I don't love these long games, especially as somebody who has to edit these videos and everything. Like, it takes forever to edit these videos. Yeah, these invoke cards are too good. And aggro games are pretty fun to play, but it doesn't have to be, like, all aggro. Right, but there's too much card advantage in Targon. It's undeniable that there's too much. Okay. Let's see. Let's play you. We'll play a Great Beyond here.
Her light is our sword, her warmth our armor.
I guess I should have done this first. It worked. Do we win? Is the game over? Oh, right, they had an elusive blocker. Right. Why did I forgot about that. I forgot they had an elusive blocker. Oh, I could just challenge that with the serpent. Sorry, I was kind of, you know, I've been, you know, reading chat, doing this, playing. I forgot they had an elusive blocker, my bad. It happens. Okay, well, let's play on for another half hour now. My bad. Alright, they got an Immortal Fire now. I don't know if I really want to... I don't know what to do. I guess I'll just play this thing. And then I'll open attack and maybe challenge something with a serpent, maybe not. Alright, so I guess open attack doesn't kill them. Immortal fires. So if that's like a fast speed removal spell, you know, like a single combat, kills my 7/7, we put him down to 1. Why didn't they just hush my challenger before attacking? Then they could have blocked my 7/7, and I guess that still would have been lethal. Never mind. Alright, Ezreal Vi. Look at that. See, Targon Mirror putting Puppy to sleep back there. Alright, so this time we're not playing against Targon. That's good. Glimpse Beyond is good against like Ezreal with the targeting and everything, but I'm just going to go ahead and mulligan. No, I'll keep Vengeance. We're going to want Vengeance for the late game. Cool. Double Star Shaping's pretty slow, but this is, you know, going to be, again, another slow matchup.
Night flowers upon my blade.
Tis annoying. Tis annoying.
Embrace the night.
Smells like opportunity.
Alright, well, even up still. We both have 4 cards. Both have spent all of our mana. Back to being even. No! Not that card. That card's good.
What do we have here?
Could hush it, I suppose. But I'm just gonna get rid of it. I'm not giving them free spells. All of my spells are amazing. I'm not giving them any for free. Alright, Comet or Traveler? Comet. Yeah.
Daylight warms the heart and lights the way.
Yeah, the pickpockets were amazing. Definitely. Comet is for Ezreal to obliterate Ezreal so Ezreal doesn't die and then be able to have like a harrowing or whatever and bring it back. Honestly, not sure if it's even worth it playing the goat. Turn on Pill Cascade. Which is fine. It's fine. I have a 3/4. I think I can take a hit from a 3/4. Really, Glimpse Beyond? Could have showed up earlier. Okay, first Ledros down. I mean, it's one of these two, right? Like, the Cosmic Rays I don't care about, the Destroyer or Living Legends. Living Legends could be a little tough with me having so many cards in hand. but still like the destroyer, right? Like they're gonna be a Shadow Isles removal deck, so like they'll be able to, you know, just use like a go hard or whatever, get rid of the spell shield, a Vile Feast, something like that, and then Vengeance. Oh, stop playing that card. Stop playing that card. That card's great. That's the best card in their deck. Hey, Alino. I'm doing good. Yeah, the Cosmic would obliterate Ezreal. I feel like Living Legends can maybe do a little bit more than that, though. Cards.
Her flowers bring the moonlight with them.
Yeah, the pickpocket was a great counter to my deck, especially for how what my hand looks like with all these, you know, how this has been. The pickpocket has been awesome. I'm fully expecting them to kill my Nocturne.
Lunari, rise.
Or not. See, fully expecting them to kill the Nocturne. Okay, Maximus. Ephemeral Callista with Go Hard if possible. Equinox is good against Ledros. I don't care about Moonglow. That's one of these two. Moonsilver will just help me like play all this other stuff though. I'll just take the Moonsilver. Alright, so let's see. Maximus has a donation deck. So I go to 5. Or do I use my Hush? I'm not sure if I should use my Hush or go to 5. Actually, probably, because I guess this Ezreal's going to level up. I guess I should probably use the Hush. Yeah, Unspeakable Horror, awesome. That was pretty good. Getting cards out of my hand is not the worst thing ever with me having Living Legends. Yeah, I think, yeah, Destroyer or Living Legend. I'm still glad we have the Living Legends instead of Destroyer. Hey, Andre. Welcome from Italy.
Calm mind and open heart greet the night.
Only one? Cool. You want to pass? That sounds pretty good to me. Yeah. Fine.
Thank you.
I don't expect them to be able to say, you know, like, have anything that buffs up the power of this thing. It's not something I'm expecting. I like Doom Beast, that's a good card. I love Pale Cascade, that's a better card.
Bask in her radiant blessing.
Oh man, Targon cards are... they are quite silly. Are they playing Glimpse Beyond? I suppose it's possible. They've done a very good job shielding Ezreal so far. I'm not sure about that second destroyer. Okay. No Glimpse Beyond, that's good.
Devotion through battle.
Two.
Return anew.
All right, so we each have six cards. We've removed two Ledros. One was Vengeance. I know I could wait till like they do something else. But then I'm just not spending any mana if I just wait. Right, like if I pass turn, they could...
tonight we'll bring them to justice.
Pass. Well, this is not the best.
Cloaked in moonlight.
Yeah, I shouldn't grab that other destroyer. Could have written in the stars. Their unspeakable horrors, though, creating these Cygnuses have been a very big deal. Targon's not easy to play, though, also, because when you have so many cards, you have so many options all of the time. You know, we're on, like, turn 20 or whatever, and we still have a ridiculous number of options, and so it's not easy to play, either. Love this.
I've become who I was always meant to be. I am more myself than ever.
I like keeping the Unspeakable Horror available for double Mystic Shot. That's what I basically wanted to do this turn. That's what I was trying to say. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, that Nocturne changes. Oh, I should have just cast it right there. Oh, well. I guess I get this thing attacked with this thing. Yeah, I should have just played that Unspeakable Horror right there. I forgot that was Nocturne's Unspeakable Horror, not a regular one. Should have played it. Just gone to five. Okay, get another one. But still, I'd rather be at five. Trickster... obviously playing the destroyer would be nice, but I'm at four and that may backfire in some form or fashion. Honestly, everything here may backfire in some form or fashion.
Mm-hmm.
I was hoping for the Lifesteal Sisters.
Sunlight guide you, my brethren.
All right, back to five. You have a third Ledros? Renin Stars could give me another Unspeakable Horror. Possibly. It's more likely that I hit a Diana, though.
Stars like jewels on the cloak of night.
I'm just trying to think of like what my best play is against Mystic Shots. Playing the Diana or waiting. Yeah, I don't have a play against Mystic Shot, I guess. So I'm positive I should have won this game. I'm absolutely positive. That's the thing, when you have, you know, I probably had, what, you know, hundreds of decisions that I made that game, and I'm positive that I had the cards that I could have won that game. But it's not easy when you have hundreds of decisions because you have, you know, just all sorts of card advantage and you just never run out of cards. It's not easy to always make the correct decisions. And so I'm positive that I should not have lost that game, but I did. All right, playing against scouts. This one's going to be much easier to predict what they're going to be doing. With that being said, I don't even know if I'm supposed to keep this other Solari Priestess. It's another card that's pretty slow. Alright, so we know that they have the spell, the 2 mana, make a 2-1 challenger. We know they have that card. It's a card they 100% have in hand. Or, I guess not necessarily 100%, because I guess they could have passed wanting me to do something. They could have, like, Brightsteel Protector, right? Like, they wanted me to do something, they were going to Brightsteel Protector. That could be an option. All right, so that's a trade I'll definitely take. Ugh. Evershade Stalker does not help in this matchup. Do I want to? I guess I have two Diana. So it's basically, do I want to trade Diana for another Sharp Side if they have a second? That's not super.
I've got your back.
Yeah, I was gonna say. Yep. So it was Brightsteel Protector. Okay.
No more lies. I will be heard.
It's not that likely that they would have another Sharp Side. That's why Diana's great. Diana champion spell. Very great. Casting Evershade Stalker would level up Diana. All three of these are awesome. This is a great answer to Quinn. All right, deal four, deal one. I think I'm gonna take that. In her radiant blessing.
Demacian needs heroes.
Now and forever.
Find your path in the dark and follow no false light. No more lies.
And just get to play infinite pill cascades when you play Diana, which is pretty nice. Infinite pill cascade.
Nothing gets between me and my mark.
Well, something may get in between. You never know. Do wish I had another mana for Pale Cascade slash Sharp Sight for Diana, but oh well. Yeah. That one's over. See, playing against Aggro, a lot more enjoyable than playing against Targon. Game's over in 5-10 minutes. We won. Alright, playing against aggro again. Good. This one's gonna be a little bit bigger aggro. I'll keep this. If they didn't have a turn one play, I wouldn't play this, but with them having a turn one play, I'll have my 2-1 to be able to block it immediately. I would obviously prefer to have Space Sketcher block that thing, but I also just don't want to take damage.
This land is ours. And here's where I'd paint my
I feel like a 4-1 could be good here. And I do like that the 4-1 costs 1 mana, so that because next turn we're going to have 3 mana and the attack token, so I can go Charger Diana next turn. Where if I took like Messenger, I could go like Messenger Diana.
Heart and Riven.
Alright, don't have enough mana for Pale Cascade, also. What's up, Nocturne? Sure. Sure.
Even a fragment snuffs out lies.
Yeah, Hush is brutal. Brutal.
Sunlight guide you, my brethren.
Alright. Like, the deal four, deal one, like, they're probably gonna have some larger units now. That's a larger unit. Speaking of larger units.
No more lies. Face your heretic.
The plus two, that 6/5. It's a little much. Yeah, I could do the 4 quick attack. Right here, the 5th point of health, a little much. Guess I shouldn't use that hush yet. But yeah, I decided to take the Traveler to look for some bigger things, more impactful things.
Mine is the hand of Noxus.
Okay. Cool. You have the hand of Noxus. Cool, cool. Sure, that's something everybody cares about.
Myself than ever.
You have found your own way in the darkness.
Just by my hand.
Back, heretic. Open your eyes. Cloaked in silver light.
Alright, planning on doing this, then Black Spear on that one. So am I playing you, Priestess, next turn? I think the answer is actually no. I'll wait a turn on you. I'm gonna play Nocturne.
Strike when the moment is right. Night flowers upon my blade. The promise of a new moon upon you, Bloom Tender.
The night is fading.
Moonlight cloaks the land in silver. The moon is our queen. The night, her kingdom.
Okay, so we'll have Diana challenge this thing.
No more face your heretic.
Yeah, I'll quick attack and everything. So that's number three for Nocturne. You can see these last two games. How just brutal our deck is against aggro. Like any deck that's like trying to attack. Our deck is just brutal. It's really like the Aurelion Soul deck is like kind of the only thing I'm scared of. Like the super long invoke, those invoke games like where they have Aurelion Soul. I know we did end up losing to that Ezreal deck. That one was a little weird. You know, they had all those box, you know, the box and they had the triple Ledros. And even with that, I'm sure I could have won, you know, just kind of gained a good amount of experience there. I'm sure I could have won. I'm sure, you know, I'm sure I had, like, the game lasted forever. I'm sure I had plenty of decisions in that game, and I know I could have won if I would have taken different lines and everything. But yeah, I mean, so you could really see, like, how good our deck is those last two games, though, especially against a lot of the metagame. You know, most of the metagame is trying to attack. And I think this deck is just awesome against all those kind of decks that are trying to attack. Hush is ridiculous. And then, you know, like Black Spear is a good removal spell, but Hush is ridiculous. But Diana and Nocturne are really good champions at controlling the board. We saw that, you know, those last two games, Diana did a ton of work those last two games. You just kind of have to play patient. You don't just like throw down your stuff right away. You know, play patient, make sure you're turning on Nightfall and everything like that. But then, you know, like, so you really control the board with your Nocturne and your Diana, and then allow your top end to take over if you get there. But, yeah, like, so this deck's really awesome. You know, both of those, you know, like, yeah, we win 3-2, but I'm very confident in this deck. I'm probably more confident in winning with this deck than the Aurelion Soul Leona, even though I know the Aurelion Soul Leona had a little bit better record in these just short five games. But yeah, I really enjoy playing this deck. I really like it, and I particularly enjoy playing it like those last two games against those kind of matchups, the Targon ones that take an hour aren't as enjoyable. But overall, that's the state of the game right now. We'll kind of see what happens, like, for the next balance patch in January. We'll see if they do anything with Targon. But yeah, like right now, as you can tell, as I talked about at the very beginning with the Aurelion Soul Leona deck, right now what we're basically doing is like these would be like three decks that would play in a seasonal tournament right now, and you can see they're all Targon decks because they're all Targon and they all have like three Hush, right? Because Targon's just incredible. And you just want to play Invoke Cards, Hush, and a bunch of other stuff with them. All right, but there we go. There's Nightfall Control. So this is a different deck, though. This is a deck that nobody else is really playing. You know, I just built this like I said about a week ago, and I've been playing it off stream. Give this one a try. You know, those all y'all on YouTube, let me know how it goes. You know, let me, you know, try this deck out yourself, see if you like it. If you like it, you know, let me know in the comments things you like, don't like about the deck, all that kind of stuff. You know, if you want something different, that's a very competitive deck that's different from what anybody else is doing, this could be for you. All right, but that's it for Nightfall Control. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.